four students graduated from the Defense Threat Reduction Agency's interpreting course for Russian language February 15, which is a high-level course only offered by the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center in Monterey, California.
Today's our guest speaker is Mr. Musgrave, Director of the On-Site Inspection and Building Capacity Directorate. Mr. Musgrave, the floor is yours.
The Director of DTRA's On-Site Inspection and Building Capacity Directorate, Mr. David Musgrave, welcomed the graduates to the organization for a challenging yet rewarding career among a small number of consecutive interpreters within the Department of Defense. A precondition for employment as a military interpreter with DTRA is successfully passing the course.
You were all handpicked from your field assignments for this. And not all who started made it to the end. Your success here speaks to your potential and the challenges that lie ahead, and will continue to test you to the limits.
Service members can expect to work with delegations from many of the former Soviet republics on missions to further U.S. national interests and relationships. Their primary duty will be to serve as representatives of the U.S. government as they interpret during inspections at facilities basing nuclear capabilities or conventional forces and ensure that treaty and agreement obligations are being fulfilled.
Because you would be expected to operate independently, I want you all to remember you're an NCO first, an interpreter second. While your expertise is important, your leadership and dedication to service is paramount. Use the opportunity of your assignment at DTRA to further advance your career professionally and to achieve some of your harder to reach personal goals. You'll be surrounded by hand-picked senior leaders with enormous collective military and government experience who are motivated to see you succeed. So make sure to capitalize on the valuable resource.
Just 6 months before the dissolution of the Soviet Union, a bilateral strategic arms reduction treaty was signed with the U.S. in July 1991. The treaty would be the most complex arms control treaty in history, designed to reduce and limit strategic offensive arms, immediately barring the signatories from deploying more than 6,000 nuclear warheads and some 1,600 intercontinental ballistic missiles. In 1996, a second START treaty was ratified. As a result of working relations and increasing partnerships between the two nations, the DLIFLC found itself increasingly tasked to teach Russian to higher levels of proficiency. In 2001, START II was signed, which expired in 2009, leading to the signing of the new START Treaty signed in 2010.
We are in the 11th, almost the 12th year of that treaty, and it expires in about 3 years. So that is a very important treaty. Once it expires, there's no other extension between the United States and Russia. So that treaty itself is going to evolve into a series of negotiations for a potentially new treaty in the future, at least we're hoping by 2026. So these students will be around when a new treaty comes into play, hopefully. But also, these students will have an opportunity to be a part of any negotiations that might occur between now and the time that the New START Treaty expires.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of DTRA Class 0222.